Former President Thabo Mbeki has paid tribute to the late struggle stalwart advocate Nathaniel Masemola. Masemola hailed from Limpopo. He was in exile in Zambia, where he played a prominent role in building of a strong local government in that country. Mbeki said the contribution made by Masemola should be always remembered.
I first met Putnet and his late first dear wife, Sis Thelma, 50 years ago in Lusaka, Zambia. This was when I returned permanently to our continent, Africa, having spent about 8 years in Europe at university and other training facilities. I was returning to Lusaka to join the headquarters of the African National Congress, the ANC. Of course, Lusaka was not just any town or city in Zambia. It was and remains the capital city of the Republic. When I arrived, the Republic of Zambia was only in its 7th year of independence. And yet Lusaka struck me as an already established, decent and well-ordered and clean capital city, and not clearly some nondescript backwater of a town. It did not take long for me to find out that the municipal manager, or chief executive officer of this city, the town clerk, was one of our own. The black South African, Mr. Nathaniel Masemola. To add to the pleasant surprise, because I had not imagined one of these black South Africans managing a city, I came to know that here we're also speaking of an old member of our movement, the ANC. It was indeed a matter of great pride that even as we continued our struggle to liberate our country and sought the support of the independent African states in this regard, at the same time, we're also making a meaningful contribution to the success of the sister countries, as did Butnet through the successful management of the capital city of independent Zambia. In this context, I recall a friendly discussion that some of us had with town clerk Net Masemola. We suggested to him that the city council should devote more resources to improving the roads in what were called high-density areas, the townships, and not just focus on the roads in the low-density areas, the suburbs. But Net agreed with us that this was indeed desirable. However, he gave us a short lesson in the management of municipal finances and the development of urban areas. He pointed out that the relatively highly developed infrastructure in the low-density areas represented an important part of the asset base of the city. And one of the tasks of the city council was to protect the value of this asset and not allow it to depreciate because of lack of maintenance. A pothole in the middle of a paved street, anyway, posed a serious challenge because it meant the beginning of the destruction of the wealth represented by the road as a whole, and therefore had to be filled as quickly as possible. He explained that this was why the city council was indeed attending to the maintenance of the paved roads in the low-density areas, appearing to be uncaring about further improving the roads in the high-density areas. What was needed was a bigger municipal budget, and therefore also a decision by council that it would indeed devote a larger part of the increase in developing the infrastructure in the high-density areas. I am mentioning this episode because it immediately communicated the message to me that here we're talking to a municipal manager who was approaching his important job with the required professional competence, and therefore that the further development of the capital city of Zambia was in safe hands, the safe hands of a member of our liberation movement. In this context, I thought that though Advocate Masemola might have acted on his own to help independent Zambia by managing Lusaka, this was consistent with the ANC policy. Already in 1962, the ANC had sent a group of senior nurses from South Africa to the then independent country of Tanganyika. This was in response to an appeal sent to the ANC by the then head of government of Tanganyika, Mwalimu Julius Nyerere, that they needed this nursing expertise both to manage the existing public health system the country, as well as further expand it to meet the health needs which the colonial system had ignored. It was in these ways as demonstrated by the selfless contribution made by such of our liberation fighters as Nedmasemola.